The weirdest thing is looking down at your feet and seeing your feet make that motion again. The trial run for an exoskeleton for quadriplegics and stuff. And I was like, hey, that's me. So not being able to feel it at the same time, but still like looking down and being like, oh yeah, that's what my feet used to do. I totally forgot that they did that. Left foot, right foot, left foot, right foot. It's weird. I realize as I'm standing on my own two feet with the exoskeleton, I'm like, could not stop smiling because I was like, this is pretty cool, you know, I'm on my own two feet.
Weeks after graduating high school, Ricky Chang suffered from a life-changing BMX accident. At a time when most young adults are on a path to independence, the spinal cord injury confined him to a wheelchair. He hasn't been able to walk ever since, until now, 8 years later.
Had to relearn how to eat, drink, talk, breathe, which was tough. I'm a C4, C5, complete spinal cord injury, Asia A. Rolls right off the tongue.
Advancements in robotics technology have made exoskeleton clinical trials more common, but being accepted into a program is highly selective.
The exoskeleton really offers that opportunity to be able to move around environments. I think for spinal cord injury, that's really important because, again, they've got perfect ability to, you know, kind of act on what, you know, they want to do. They can plan it out, and even though they can't use their muscles. And so the exoskeleton offers us the ability to kind of get out.
Standing up, you know, after this, sitting down doesn't seem as cool.
There's also looking at how to maybe use people's brain signals to control the exoskeletons, and they're making a lot of progress in that as well. Basically having some kind of way to read brain signal and then produce movement with a robotic device, but it would be the person's own intention that kind of moves the exoskeleton. So right now, the way that Indigo works is the person has to do kind of a compensatory movement, and I have to, like, for someone like Ricky, I have to assist him. So I have to assist him in a lean forward in order to activate the device. And this would be like he'd be thinking about activating the device and it would happen.
There's not anything available for me. I mean, there's, you know, things you can do out of the country and stuff. But the problem with that is if you go do a trial with stem cells and say it doesn't work, then you're automatically blacklisted from any, like, American clinical trials and stuff.
I bet LeBron would see this.
I'm gonna be the next Space Jam.
It's all about, like, finding the right trial to be like, is this the one that I'm gonna put all my eggs in this basket, you know?
Cheesesteak.
Where's my cheesesteak?
Size.
Just where I kind of like put my arms behind me and like sit and relax and like, it's the day on the beach.
Be quiet.
Yep. This is why.
I see the use of the exoskeleton as continuing to keep people healthy. And I think there are gonna be new medical advances and new technological advances that if Ricky isn't doing something like the exoskeleton right now, he might not be able to take advantage of 10 years from now, because this is keeping him healthy, it's keeping his joints loose, keeping good circulation. If I don't do that now, he could really miss an opportunity in 10 years when there's something else he could take advantage of.
I have some damn good friends, is what I'll say. I have friends that you didn't think were possible to even have, you know? But I didn't know, like, the extent of, like, what people are willing to do for each other in times of need. Like, I've had friends just do, I can almost say, like, too much for me.
I have someone cleaning behind me, and then after that, someone in front of me spreading rose petals as I go forward. No? That was funny. Whatever. Coming to America, that movie.
Oh, that's a great movie.
Yeah, with Eddie Murphy. Yeah, like they're all walking on rose petals the entire time. Great.
Ricky's injury hasn't derailed his dreams and goals. He hosts a podcast with his friend and has plans to start college to study science. Most recently, he experienced fame as an internet celebrity.
I was just sitting in front of my TV one day. I'd just come home from physical therapy, and I was bored, you know, those times when you're just browsing your phone, seeing what pictures you have on there. It's like, and I just saw the picture of me in the exoskeleton. I was like, yeah, that's kind of a cool picture. I mean, I put it on my Instagram, my Facebook before. Let's see how this does on Reddit, you know, just for shits and giggles. I posted it on there, and within 30 minutes, I had like an insane amount of upvotes, and then people just comedy, you're like, yeah, hell yeah, man, congrats, congrats, you know, inspiration, blah, blah, blah.
On Reddit?
Wow.
Number 7 on pics of all time. Yeah.
Whoa! When, like, how old is Reddit?
Like, 10 years?
The way I found out was that I actually had a therapist who used to work with me text me a screenshot of it. You're on Reddit. So I was like, whoa. And then I realized, like, how terrible the face that I'm making of this picture is. So
I want to go to school, study physics, and then find a way to be able to do astronomy or something. I don't know, something space related. My ideal dream would be to somehow combine my love of comedy and my love of space into something that would be awesome. The reason I want to go to VCU is also because, you know, I've been in Manassas for, I feel like, a little bit too long. I want to experience city life for a little bit and see how it is and be able to do more things for myself, live on my own, and, you know, not have to rely on my parents because, you know, they need their own lives and stuff. And of course, I love the fact that they're willing to do anything and everything for me, but, you know, I want to be able to get to the point where, you know, I can finally give back to them for everything that they've done for me.
So, this is the part you should put in there. Someone has to ask me, hey, Ricky, what's it like in the chair?
Hey, Ricky, what's it like to be in the chair?
I can't stand it.